Earth has been around for more than 4.5 billion years. Meanwhile, life on Earth is estimated to have begun 3.7 billion years ago, with complex life forms surfacing just a billion or so after that. It is kind of strange that in the long span of time, only our species that have sprung from a few million-year-old genus have reached the point of technological advancement. So, why is it that no other species, most who arrived here earlier than us, have evolved to build cities with governments, creating stunning works of art and architecture, and invent complex yet highly useful means of communication? Did they simply not reach the level of sophistication in the evolutionary game? Or perhaps they actually did, and we were just unaware of that fact. Did an advanced civilization really exist way before our own? Maybe a race that isn't human? If they did, how would we know? To answer this question, let's first set the clock in the year 2018. Two scientists, Adam Frank and Gavin Smith, one an astrophysicist at University of Rochester, and the other a climatologist and director of NASA Goddard Institute for Space Studies, presented a rather intriguing hypothesis. If an industrial civilization existed millions of years ago, is there any way of knowing how through geological record? In other words, would we know if there was a highly advanced civilization before the dawn of humanity? Is it possible to detect evidence with our current technology? A civilization would have surely left its mark in one way or another. We would have found bits and pieces of its once glorious existence, artifacts, ruins, and even skeletal remains. That is, if the civilization in question is only several thousand years old. But what about millions of years after the fact? Or tens of millions of years? What about hundreds of millions? Do we have a way of knowing? Because humans have only existed for around a few million years or so, counting in archaic human ancestors and other hominin cousins, the kind of civilization we're talking about here isn't human at all. If your guess are lizard people, you're correct. Somewhat. The Silurian Hypothesis. Called the Silurian Hypothesis, this thought experiment explores this very idea. Named after a fictional race from the Doctor Who series, Silurians are an evolved species of reptiles who went into hibernation after a worldwide cataclysm threatened to wipe them out. In other words, they are a Homo reptilian species that predates humans. And since a race of reptilians, aka dinosaurs, was indeed the dominant life form on this planet, an intelligent and advanced species that evolved from them was also the likeliest contender. Before you get excited on the fact that this idea was published as a scientific journal, hold your horses. Both Frank and Smith don't actually endorse this idea. In fact, they think it's highly unlikely that there was a highly advanced civilization in the past long before ours. Frank and Smith's main purpose for this study is to ask the question of whether an extinct civilization is still detectable after millions and millions of years, even after the direct evidence is gone. So how could we know? In search of evidence, artifacts, and architecture. We can prove the existence of an advanced civilization by finding what is called a direct evidence. This means undeniable and verifiable proof of such civilizations. Ruins of city buildings, like temples, houses, and government centers, statues of revered figures and religious monuments, artifacts great and small, from daily household tools, like ceramics and pottery, to more refined weapons. Written records like scrolls and tablets, objects that are clearly made by an intelligent being, but we have no clear idea what they were for. These are just some of the things we can usually find in digging of archaeological sites dating a few thousand years. It's thanks to those artifacts that we have quite a clear picture of what these civilizations were like. More importantly, that they have once existed. But even these tangible legacy of their handiwork has already been subjected to the ravages of time. More often than not, there were even a few pieces left that even in its discovery is a feat in itself. The remains of a civilization dating 10,000 years back would struggle to survive to this day. What more of a civilization that goes hundreds or even million years ago? Suffice to say, all of these have a long crumbled to dust. What about geological records then? Adam Frank himself stated that it doesn't go back past the start of Quaternary, which is a 2.5 million years ago. Therefore, if an ancient millions of years old civilization in question did in fact exist, all of what remained after its demise would have returned to Earth. So if we can't find objects created by a long-lost civilization, our next hope would be able to find the ones who created them, or their fossilized remains at least. In search of evidence, fossil records. In contrast to artifacts and ruins, there's a type of evidence that could last for millions of years even when the surface of the Earth has changed drastically. Fossil records. Surely there are fossils that we can find as proof of this ancient civilization. And if there weren't any, then it just conclusively proves there was no such thing. Turns out, it wasn't as simple as that. Fossilization occurs when a dead organism is covered quickly by layers of sediment. This prevents animals, decay, and erosion to destroy the organism's remains, preserving them for years to come. As of the moment, scientists estimate that only less than 1% of all organisms were fossilized, and 99% of these fossilized remains were marine animals. Thus, if a civilization existed tens of millions of years ago, it's next to impossible that fossil remains of its intelligent inhabitants have formed, much less survived to this day. Knowing that we can't rely on artifacts, ruins, nor fossils to find a very old civilization, now what? Adam and Frank suggested finding for an indirect evidence, namely, subtle impact of such civilization on the planet. In search of evidence, technological signature. We don't know exactly what kind of civilization our supposed predecessors had, if they in fact had even existed. We don't even know for sure what kind of evidence we're looking for. In this case, we can only make assumptions based on our model that we know, ourselves. If humans suddenly disappeared tomorrow, would a visiting alien 100 million years into the future know we existed? Mind that this is already far into the future of a timeline where humans were extinct and the landscape of the Earth may have already changed dramatically. So given that everything in this subject to entropy and time, would we leave traces of our once global civilization for those aliens to find? Surprisingly, yes, we would. Hypothetically, if all of our skyscrapers leveled and all of them remaining artifacts have turned to dust, there are still faint but solid traces that we once walked the Earth. The Anthropocene epoch is a proposed geological time that we currently lived in. There isn't a consensus yet when this epoch supposedly started, but it's used to describe the time when humans have a direct and considerable impact on Earth. From the Greek words anthropos, meaning human, and cena, which means recent, Anthropocene is thus the epoch of humans when we shape the world according to our will. Because of our extensive use on the planet's natural resources, there's a bound to be a lasting impact on it, aka a geological footprint. Our pervasive mining and deforestation activities have brought on significant changes on the planet in just one thing. Plastic pollution is another. Even if plastics decompose in a few hundred years, they will just turn into microscopic particles that could survive for longer periods. The biggest example would be our use of fossil fuel. Humanity has released a staggering 0.5 trillion tons of fossil carbon since the 1700s. Releasing a huge amount of carbon dioxide back into the air could have a long-lasting and dramatic impact on our planet, such as the rising of global temperatures. So, if aliens would visit a humanless Earth 100 million years into the future, they would know we existed once upon a time by studying these techno signatures. Considering that this is how we leave our mark on Earth in case we get wiped out tomorrow, it is also possible that a former global civilization have left similar metaphorical handprints on our planet. Interestingly, there was a period of history that is a bit similar to what we are experiencing today, PETM. The Paleocene-Eocene Thermal Maximum, or PETM, was relatively a brief period of short intervals of maximum temperature. Occurring approximately 56 million years ago, this strange event persisted for 200,000 years. During this period, global average temperatures would rise periodically by more than 5 to 8 degrees Celsius. The temperature was so hot that even the sea temperatures in the Arctic went up to 23 degrees Celsius. But how in the world did it get to this point? According to scientists, the main possible culprit of PETM was a curious disturbance in the carbon cycle in the atmosphere. In other words, a massive amount of carbon dioxide was released into the oceans and the atmosphere. The sudden increase of carbon dioxide in the seas and air have caused the global temperatures to rise as well, triggering the PETM. With the change of temperature comes after effects such as wetter climates, melting of ice caps, rise in sea levels, mass extinction of certain oceanic creatures, and a drop of oxygen levels in the oceans. Does this sound familiar? Yes, because this phenomenon is very similar to what we're experiencing today, our very own global warming. So, why is it that the global average temperatures mysteriously rose to these levels 56 million years ago? What caused the global warming back then? Was it another pre-human civilization? Unfortunately, this may not also be the case, and interesting and a bit horrifying it is for the global warming back in the day to be caused by another advanced species, scientists have another idea in mind. They call it the Methane Burp Hypothesis. The Methane Burp Hypothesis is a theory that explains the PETM. It was when massive amounts of methane hydrates warmed up in the ocean and was eventually released into the atmosphere. Methane is a powerful greenhouse gas and thus contributed to the warming of the world. But this isn't necessarily caused by a direct intervention of another species. Another possible theories are powerful volcanic eruptions and comet impact, which is, as you remember, have likely killed the dinosaurs. Moreover, the PETM lasted for over 200,000 years and have risen and fallen throughout this period. Meanwhile, humans have only been around for a few thousand years and got into industrial area for well over 300. Compared to the PETM, temperatures have spiked drastically within this relatively minuscule amount of time. No thanks to us releasing massive amounts of greenhouse gases into the air, such as when we were burning fossil fuels. Now, does PETM's longevity ultimately disprove the existence of a prior advanced civilization? Not exactly, especially when you put it into account the meaning of an advanced civilization, going beyond the Earth for evidence. When we were talking about advanced civilization, the first thing that comes to our minds are the kind of life we have today. iPhones, skyscrapers, the internet, Tesla's self-driving cars, complex education systems, railroads, airplanes, hospitals, and medicines. Some of us might not even think more futuristic, setting like a commercialized and easy space travel. On the other hand, when we talk about civilizations in the past, especially the new ones being discovered, we also call them advanced. Well, relatively advanced. Now, what if the pre-human civilization we're looking for did exist, but only they didn't get to the point where we are now? Something like a pre-industrial civilization. So if an industrial civilization that existed millions of years ago is already hard to ascertain, what about one that is akin to a medieval period? If a catastrophe happened before they could even reach their industrial period, the possibility of finding traces of their civilization would be almost impossible, considering that they may not have used fossil fuels or a bit of it. They won't leave techno-signatures that would last till our timeline. On the other hand, what if they are advanced, maybe far more advanced than us, but used a different kind of energy? One that is more sustainable and wouldn't cause a massive shift in the global temperature. The more advanced a civilization becomes, the more they need a more powerful but highly sustainable source of energy. So, would we never ever know them? With our current technology, finding a civilization that predates humanity, if they even existed, would be next to impossible. However, there might be another way we can know. And no, I'm not talking about creating a time machine. Rather, I'm talking about space archaeology. In its essence, space archaeology is a field of study that attempts to study and preserve archaeological sites on our other celestial bodies. So if our predecessors reached a high level of technology, they may have surpassed even us. It's also possible they have visited our closest neighbors, aka the Moon and Mars. Still, if they somehow visited these other planets, they might have left artifacts. But wouldn't they be destroyed after millions of years? Well, not exactly, because artifacts would likely be preserved for a long time because of the lack of elements that could destroy them, like wind and water. So if we couldn't find direct evidence on our planet, maybe we can in another place. As of the moment, there is very little evidence that our ancient pre-human race lived long time ago. However, it's also not impossible. The more our technology develops, the more we will likely find proof, if they did exist. Keep the adventure going. Navigate to our playlist. Curious for more? Explore the following episode. Don't stop now. Watch the next video in the series.